Hi students, again we are going to see the same lesson, paths and holes. Next topic, greedy gatekeepers. What is mean by greedy? Greedy means selfish. In Tamil we have to tell perasai. Okay, greedy gatekeepers. Remember Birbal, the clever minister of the king Akbar. Math magic class 4. Page 14. Already in class 4, we knew about Birbal and Akbar in long and short lessons. Next, do you know how he became a minister? Let's see. Birbal was then a young boy living in a village. He was a very clever and could write poetry. He thought he would try his luck in the king's court. So he took some of his poems and set off for the city. When he reached the outer gate, see, this is the outer gate of the palace. He was stopped by the gatekeeper. Hey, stop there. Where are you going? Shouted the gatekeeper. See, Birbal said, I am a poet. I want to see King Akbar and show my poems to him. Replied by the poet. Oh, you are a poet. The king is kind. He will surely give you a prize. I will let you in if you give me a 1/10 of your prize. See, listen. I will let you in if you give 1/10 of your prize. This is the conversation between the gatekeeper and Birbal. Turn the next page. Young Birbal agreed since he had no other way. When he went it, the gatekeeper calculated if he gets 100 gold coins, I will get dash gold coins. See what the gatekeeper asked. First gatekeeper, 1/10 of price. The price money is 100 gold coin means how many coins the gatekeeper will get? 1/10 into 100. See, 0, 0 cancel. So, what is that? In another way, we have to write 100/10. 0, 0 cancel. I will get 10 gold coins. The poet came to the second gatekeeper. This gatekeeper also said, I will let you in if you give me a 2/5 of your price. 2/5. 2/5 means 2/5 of your price. The poet agreed. The gatekeeper happily calculated, the poet will get at least 100 coins. So I will get dash gold coins. So 2/5 into 100. So we can cancel. 5 2s are 10. 5 2s are 10. Next, here 0. So 5 20, that is 100. 2 into 20, that is 40. So I will get 40 gold coins. Next, the poet reached the last gate. The gatekeeper said, I will allow you to see the king. Only if you give me a half of the price means 1/2. The poet had no other way. He agreed and went inside. The gatekeeper thought, today is a great day. If he gets 100 gold coins, I will get 100 divided by 2. Half means 1/2. So 2 5s are 10. The 0 will come here. So I will get 50 gold coins. But if he gets 1000 coins, wow, I will get, see, 1000 divided by half, 1/2, that is divided by 2. 2 5s are 10, that these zeros and all you put it in these. So I will get 500 gold coins. The king was very happy with the poems and said, the king was very happy with the poems and said, your work is very good. And he said, your work is very good. You can ask anything as your price. You can ask anything as your price. My lord, I want 100 slab. My lord, I want 100 slab. What? 100 slab? They are blinking. The king is blinking. The king was shocked. Why he asked 100 slab? What happened after that? Birbal said, yes, your greedy gatekeepers asked the price amount. So first you give the price amount to the gatekeepers. So first gatekeepers get 10 slab. Second gatekeeper get 40 slabs. And third gatekeeper get 50 slabs. So what part of the price did the poet get? Zero part. Next, patterns in parts. Make a different patterns by coloring some squares in the grids B, C, D. What part of the grid did you color? What part of the grid remained white and right here? See A. How many in blue color? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 in blue color. And white, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 blue, 8 white. First, before that, we want to know the total number of grid in the square. See, row. First, you have to calculate the row. 1, 2, 3, 4 rows. Column, next. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 rows into 4 columns. So, 4 fours are 60. This square grid is made up of 16 square. The grid is made up of 16 squares. 8 blue and 8 by 16 blue and 8 by 16 white. Now I am going to draw the different patterns in B. See. This is one pattern, again here one pattern. Now look at here, in 16 squares I have colored 4 parts in blue. So I have written 4 by 16 in blue. Remaining, how many is white? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 by 16 is white. Next, here also, I divided into 2 equal parts. So 2 equal parts means like that it will come. 8 by 16 blue, 8 by 16 white. Next, D. See, I have colored 4 blue and then 12 white. Like this it will come. So here you write 4 by 16 blue. Next, 12/16 white. Next, look at a grid A again. Is the grid colored by, see, option A, 1/2 blue, 1/2 white, and B, 2/4 blue, 2/4 white, C, 3/8 blue, 5/8 white, and D, 4/8 blue and 4/8 white. Mark into mark on the wrong answer. See, look at the grid, A grid. See, 1/2 blue, 1/2 white. The both numerator and denominator is divided by 8. See, if we cancel, 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 16. So, 1/2 blue, 1/2 white. So, the both numerator and denominator divided by 8. Look at the B option, 2/4. Here, the both denominator is divided by 4. Look at here. 4 2s are 8, 4 4s are 16. So 2/4 blue, 2/4 white. Next, D. 4/8 blue, 4/8 white. This both denominator and numerator, numerator and denominator is divided by 2. Look at here. 2 4s are 8. Then 2 8s are 16. So 4/8 blue, 4/8 white. But here, 3/8 blue, 5/8 white. This is the wrong parts. So you put the into mark.
Next, draw groups of 16 squares and make the patterns with. See, they are giving two options, A and B. First, we are going to do A option. 2/8 of red and 1/2 part of yellow and 1/4 part of green. Okay, first 2/8 of green, red. 2/8 into total number of squares in the grid, how many? 60. So 2/8 into 60. Now I'm going to cancel. 8 2s are 60. Next, we want to multiply. 2 into 2, that is 4. So how many parts will be red? 4 parts. Next, yellow. 1/2 into 60. Here 2 8s are 60. So how many part is yellow? 8 part is in yellow color. Next, 1/4 of part of green. 1/4 into total number of squares, 60. 4 4s are 16. So here 1 into 4, 4. What color? Green color. If we add green part, you can get the total number of square. 4 plus 8, 12. 12 plus 4, 16. We can get the whole squares. We can get the square, 16 square. Now I am going to shape it. 4 part in red color. See, 4 part. Use the 4 part in red color. Next, 8 part in yellow color. Next, 5/16. red color. Next, 1 by 2 into 16. Yellow part is 1 by 2, half of that. 2 8s are 16. So, 8 yellow part. Now, I am going to shade the square grid. First, 3 part in blue color. 3 part in blue color. Next, 5 parts in red color. 5 parts in red color. Next, 8 parts in yellow color. Remaining part. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 part in yellow color.
Next, Ramu's vegetable field. Ramu's vegetable field. Ramu's vegetable field has 9 equal parts. This is the 9 equal parts. What vegetables does he grow? What vegetables does he grow? He grows chilies, potatoes, brinjals, tomatoes and spinach. What are the vegetables does he grow? He grows chilies, potatoes, brinjals tomatoes and spinach. Next, which vegetable grow in the biggest part of his field? Which vegetable grows in the biggest part of his field? Which vegetable? See, tomatoes. Tomatoes only grows in the biggest part of his vegetables, of his field. What part in, out of 9 equal parts, tomato grows in 3 equal parts. See, 1, 2, 3. So, 3 by 9. In other ways, we can write 3, 1 is 3, 3, 3 is 9. 1 by 3 part. Next, on what part of the field does he grow potatoes? On what part of the field does he grow potatoes? See, out of 9 equal parts, the potato grows in 2 equal parts. 2 equal parts. So, here you write 2 by 9. Next, what part of the field is used to grow spinach and what part is used for brinjal? First, what part of the field is used for grow spinach? Out of 9 equal parts, spinach in only one part. So, here spinach is 1 by 9 part. Next, what part is used for brinjal? Look at here. Out of 9 equal parts, in 2 parts, the used for brinjal. So, 2 by 9. Now, you write some question by looking at this picture. By looking at this picture, you have to write some question on the next page and write the answer for that. Next, Ramu wanted to give these vegetables to his friends. Ramu wanted to give these vegetables to his friends. He gave Abu Bakr 1/5 of these tomatoes and 1/3 of the potatoes. Srija got 2 by 5, that is 2/5 of tomatoes and 3/6 of potatoes. Nancy got the rest of these vegetables. Circle Abu Bakr's share in blue color and circles Stegers share in yellow color. First, we want to count the total number of potatoes and tomatoes. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So, total number of potatoes, 80. Next, tomatoes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 tomatoes. See? Abu Bakar, 1/5 of these tomatoes and 1/3 of the potatoes. See? 1/5 of tomatoes. Next, 1/3 of the potatoes. See, total number of tomatoes is, total number of tomato is 20. Next, total number of potato is 80. Now we are going to find out for Abu Bakar shares. 1/5 of tomatoes. 1/5 of tomatoes. So 1/5 into total number of tomatoes, that is 20. How many 5 will make 20? 5 4s are 20. So he got 4 tomatoes. Next, 1/3 of potatoes. 1/3 into 18. Why? Because the total number of potato is 18. So how many 3 will make 18? 3 sixes are 18. So he got 6 potatoes. Next, Srija got 2/5 of tomatoes and 3/6 of the potatoes. 2/5 of tomatoes and 3/6 of potatoes. Again, we are going to do like this. 2/5, total number of tomatoes, 20. How many 5 will make 20? 4. 5 4s are 20. Next, 2 into 4, that is 8. So, 8 tomatoes. Next, 3/6 of potatoes. 3/6 into total number of potatoes, 18. How many 6 will make 18? 6 3s are 18. Next, we want to multiply. 3 into 3, 9. So, she got 9 potatoes. Now, look at here. What they said. Circle Abu Bakar share in blue color. Circle Stegers share in yellow color. See, Abu Bakar share 4 tomatoes and 6 potatoes. Now, I'm going to circle the Abu Bakar share in blue color. See, 4 tomatoes, 6 potatoes. Now I'm going to circle in blue color. See here, 4 tomatoes. Next, 6 potatoes. Next, circle Stegers share in yellow color. See, Stegers share is 8 tomatoes, 9 potatoes. 8 tomatoes. So, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 tomatoes in Srija shares. Next, how many potatoes? 9 potatoes. 9 potatoes. See? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, this is Srija Shah. Remaining, how many potatoes and tomatoes we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and here one is 8. So totally we have 8 tomatoes remaining. Next here, 1, 2, 3. 3 potatoes we have remaining. These vegetables got by Nancy. The next question is, how many potatoes and tomatoes did Nancy get? In easy way, we can tell 8 tomatoes and 3 potatoes. But now I am going to work out the sum. See, already 4 tomatoes got by Abu Bakr and 8 tomatoes got by Srija. First, we want to add these tomatoes. See, 8 plus 4. So, 8 plus 4, that is 12. Next, 6 potatoes got by Abu Bakr, 9 potatoes got by Srija. Next, we are going to add the potatoes. 6 plus 9, that is 15. See, total number of, we want to subtract these numbers from total numbers. Total number of tomatoes is 20 and total number of potato is 80. So, 20 minus 12. 20 minus 12, that is 8. 8 tomatoes. Next, total number of potato is 18. So, 18 minus 15 they got. 18 minus 15, that is 3. 3 potatoes. So Nancy got 8 tomatoes and 3 potatoes. So right here, 3 potatoes and 8 tomatoes. Turn the next page. Next, game, who colors the circle first? Game, who colors the circle first? This is one of the game. This game is to be played in a groups of 4. We want 4 members for this game. Each player has to make a circle as shown. See, each player has to make a circle as shown. You have to divide the circle into 12 equal parts. Next, each one has to make a 15 tokens on a slips of paper. Each one has to make a 15 tokens on a slips of paper. Write like this. 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 6. Next, 1 by 2, 12, 2 by 12, 3 by 12, 4 by 12 and up to 11 by 12. Why we didn't write 12 by 12? That is full circle. 12 divided by 12 means that is 1. That is 1 full circle. So we have to start up to 11 by 12. To make your own tokens, you make your tokens. Shuffle the tokens and make a pile in the middle of the group. Shuffle the tokens and make a pile in the middle of the group. Now you are ready to start the game. The first player takes a token from the pile, colors that part of the picture. If the first player take a 1 by 12 means he want to share the one part. Out of the 12 part, he wants to share the one part. Next, and puts the token under the pile. The next player does the same and so on. You want to play this game like this. The winner is the one who first color the circle completely. The winner is the one who first color the circle completely. You have to write who won the game. Next, what are the winner's tokens? If the winner's token is 1 by 12, next 11 by 12 means you have to write the token's number. Next, write the tokens you got. Write the tokens you got. What are the tokens you got? You write here. Next, what part of the circle did you color? What part of the circle did you color? If you colored half of the circle means you have to write 6 by 12. 6 by 12. Like that you have to write. Next, the card puzzle. The card puzzle. Look carefully at the picture and get ready to answer for 4 questions. And get ready to answer 4 questions. Are you ready? Now, look at the question. First puzzle, that is A puzzle. Divide the white area in square A into 2 equal parts. Got the answer? Was that easy? See, divide the white area in a square A into 2 equal parts. Now, look at the square A. See, now I am going to divide the white area into 2 equal parts. See, the white area is in 2 equal parts. Next, divide the white area in square B into 3 equal parts. Into 3 equal parts. It is very easy or not? Yes, it is easy to divide. Now we are going to divide the square B into 3 equal parts. Look at the square B. This is one part. You have to use the scale. This is second part. And this one is third part. Now I divide the white area into 3 equal parts. Next, divide the white area in square C into 4 equal parts. Divide the white area in square C into 4 equal parts. Now look at the square C. See, this is the square C. Now I am going to divide it into 4 equal parts. See, this one part, this is another part, this is third part, and this one is fourth part. These 4 parts are in equal. Next, D. Fourth question. Divide the white area in a square D into 7 equal parts. Into 7 equal parts. See, using the scale, you have to draw the 6 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, we divided the square D into 7 equal parts. Now, look at here. Is this bit difficult? Don't worry. You have to take your own time for the square C. Only if you have given up, look for the answer. Here comes the last question. The fourth question is the last question. Next, the world record for this 7 seconds. But you can take the minutes. This is the world record. The world record is for only 7 seconds. But you can take a minutes. Tired of thinking, look for the answer on page number 68. If you did not get the answer, have to look the page number 68. So, was that difficult or not? It is very easy. Thank you, students.